Hello ladies and gentlemen, in today's video two digital artists, me and JB Squiddy, will do our best to recreate this After Effects flipbook animation in PowerPoint. First I'll show you my result and after that we'll check out the work by JB Squiddy. This is going to be a lot of fun, so let's go! Alright, so before I show you my final result, let me share with you the rules that we have agreed on with JB Squiddy. So there has to be three animated scenes with book opening and closing animations. Each scene should last about 7 seconds and if needed, we are allowed to use illustrations from freepik.com. Okay, so let's check out my final result. Alright guys, so this was my result and it was definitely a challenge to create something like this in PowerPoint, but I'm happy with the result and now I'm looking forward to see the work by JB Squiddy. And before that, let me quickly walk you through my process of creating this flipbook. Later on, it will be really interesting to see how JB Squiddy has created his book. Okay, so the first question I had is how to actually create this page flip animation in PowerPoint. I know there is a slight transition called a page curl, which might be helpful. Let me show you how this transition looks like. It's called page curl. And as you can see, we can achieve this kind of slight transition, but I think this would not work for what we're trying to do. So the next thing that I have tried, I have basically just inserted a rectangle. Let's say this is page number one. Okay. And then I have decided to play with 3D rotation options a little bit. So let's make sure we have selected our page. Let's go to 3D rotation options. And I have selected this preset called Perspective Relaxed. All right. And now I have duplicated the slide. So to duplicate a slide, you can just hit Ctrl D or Command D to duplicate. And on the duplicate slide, let's go to 3D rotation options once again. And for the X rotation, let's type in 180 degrees. Which basically flips this page horizontally. And for the slide transitions, for this slide, let's make sure that we choose Morph. Morph will do this animation. And now as you can see, the page is flipping, but the problem is that the page is flipping alongside its center. The center is where the center has to be, but we would like this page to flip on the side, you know, as in the real books. And to achieve that, we have to do a couple of changes. So first of all, let me undo a couple of steps so that we have just a simple rectangle without any 3D rotation, just like that. Now let's make a copy. We can just hit Ctrl D to copy. Let's bring this copy to the left side. We can delete the text and let's make sure that this rectangle on the left side has no fill. It will be transparent rectangle. Let's make sure we select both of these guys and regroup them into one beautiful group. That's awesome. And now once again, we can apply this Perspective Relaxed preset. Okay, that's good. And now we have a 3D rotated group of rectangles and one of these rectangles is transparent one. All right, so now we can duplicate this slide as before. And on the duplicate slide, let's go to 3D rotation options. And for the X rotation, let's type in 180. Okay, once again, let's make sure that we're using Morph Transition. And now as you can see, the center of rotation is fixed. And now as you can see, we're getting this pretty realistic page flip effect animation in PowerPoint, and I'm really happy with how this came out. But the next challenge was how to actually construct a book with a front cover, with a side, with a back cover, and so on. And here in the selection pane, you can see all of the additional shapes that I have added to create this book. We have some pages, we have page block, we have front cover, back cover, and book side. And a few more important concepts that we have to talk about are depth and distance from ground. All of these shapes have some kind of 3D depth and as well they have some kind of distance from ground. So let's say we select this front cover, let's go to 3D rotation options. Actually, let's go to 3D format first of all, and here we have some depth, we have 10 points, all right. And in the 3D rotation options for the distance from ground, I have used 10 points. So all of these shapes that make up the book have different depths and different distances from the ground. And on this slide, you can see all of the settings that I have used for all of these different shapes. So for example, all pages have depth and distance from ground of 0 points, and page block has depth of 40 points and distance of 0 points. So here's this white page block, and it has a depth of 40 points. And at the bottom, we have a back cover. Okay. And now let me show you how we can actually flip this book and see some pages inside of this book. Alright, so first of all, let me show you how this first flip looks like. Alright, that's awesome. Alright, so now let's select this slide where this purple book is. Let's duplicate the slide. And on the duplicate slide, let's make sure we go to selection pane and select the front cover. That's good. And in the 3D rotation options for the X rotation, let's type in 180 degrees. That's awesome. Let's make sure that morph transition is activated. And now we get this beautiful front cover open animation. And here in the middle, we have this little line sticking out. This is book side. So we can just reduce the height of this book side. And morph transition should take care of the rest. Looking good. All right. So now let me show you how we can flip page number one. Let's duplicate the last slide. Once again, let's make sure page one is selected. And let's bring page one to the top of the selection pane list because we want it to be on top. And once again, for the X rotation, let's type in 180 degrees and morph transition should do the rest. Okay, so this is the technique that I have used for all of the book flips in my animation. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. And now let me show you how we can make some objects pop up on those pages once they open up. So to make it more simple, let's use a couple of trees. So let's give it a preview. One tree pops up on page number two and one tree pops up on the back of page number one. Okay, so let's select this tree on the right side. Let's copy it and let's get back to our slides where we have been working on. And let's paste one tree on page number two. Alright, now let's jump to selection pane and let's check if we can see our tree. And here it is, tree right, that's good. And by the way, as you can see, I'm using double exclamation marks. That is really useful when you are working with morph transition. Morph transition knows which object is which if you're using double exclamation marks. And now let's make sure that we bring this tree right just below page one and front cover. It has to be below these shapes. Okay, now let's copy the tree. Let's get back to previous slide, let's paste the tree, and now we can just grab this white bubble and flip this tree vertically. And once again, let's move it just below front cover and page one. And now the morph transition should do all of the magic. So let's give it a preview. So you can see page one opens and the tree pops up. That's awesome. All right, so let's add one more tree on the left side. We can hold down the control key to make a quick copy. Let's rename this tree in the selection pane. Let's call it tree left. That's good. And now let's actually leave it at the top of the selection pane because it has to be on top of the page one and on top of the front cover, just like that. Now let's just copy this tree left. Let's paste it to the previous slide. And now let's drag it to the right side. Let's use the rotation handle to rotate this tree around. We can as well position it anywhere that we wish. And here we have to position it just below the front cover and page one. All right. And this is the final result. We have one tree popping up on the back of page one and one tree on page number two. And these were all of the secrets that I have used to create my flipbook animation. And now let's check out the work by JB Squiddy. Thank you. my goodness! Wow, that's super awesome! Congratulations, JB, you did very well! I know that JB Squiddy likes creating his own illustrations in PowerPoint, and I'm sure that all of these beautiful illustrations were custom made by JB Squiddy. And as you can see, the style of JB Squiddy's work is very different from mine. Illustrations, animations look like they are from a storybook. And actually, there is a story. As you can see in the first scene, a ship is traveling somewhere. Then in a second scene, a hero picks up a sword. And in the final scene, the hero faces a dragon. Well done. And all of the animations are super awesome as well. I like how the book pages are flipping, how the waves are moving in the first scene, the sword picking animation in the second scene, and the fire sword and moving dragon in the last scene. Really well done. Subscribe to JB Squiddy. And by the way, if you would like to see more behind the scenes shots on how JB Squiddy has created his work, please go to his channel and watch his video. Link is in the video description. Alright guys, that was all for today. If we get 10,000 likes on this video, we will do one more creative challenge with JB Squiddy. Thanks to JB Squiddy and to everyone for watching. Stay happy, stay healthy, and I'll see you on my next video.